All right, today 3rd of July 2021 and 9:10 in India. So we shall start now our learning session today.
गुरुजी प्रणाम।
Today's pranam, Hari Om. Topic is the power of acceptance of what is. There is two parts of it. First part is acceptance, of course, and the next part is what is. Let me explain, start with what is type, or what is part of that, topic. So in the whole universe is called all that is. Many spiritual masters refers the manifested universe as all that is, means that's what has been manifested, created, and it is present. And as I explained earlier, that past and future is all in your mind. Only reality, truth is the now moment or present moment. So all that is, just I'm explaining for understanding purposes, spiritual understanding, all that is what is present in now moment. At present, what is manifested universe, that is all that is. It is little bit of, twisting of words, it appears to be, but I'm trying to explain exactly what that mean. So far what we have discussed is now moment is the only truth. Rest, past, future is in our mind. It can happen, it may not happen. We'll see when that now time, what is the truth? Many things can be created within a moment, so that whatever we, our thought and other ideas can perceive of the future may change in instant. And same thing, it can over in an instant. Okay, it is a reality, it is a truth. Somebody can die in an instant, just like that, it's over. Okay, so change is doesn't make a lot of time. Only our ideas flows here and there, and we think about future, talk about future, and all these kind of things. To manifest that future is not in our hand. Partially, but not fully. We are the, in ultimate level, we are the co-creator of that reality. So we are, if you see our lifetime or something, it is a big, in an infinite scale where maybe very minor part of it. Somebody has even in the history of planet Earth, somebody has explained it well, how the history of the whole Earth has been, the civilization and this history, what we think as a history, that is a human history, how long it is in terms of the overall age of a Earth. So they given one example of a calendar, annual calendar. Suppose 1st January of the calendar, the Earth was created first. What we learned in the geography, some part came out from the sun, it cooled down and things like that. So then they have, I don't remember exactly the point, but the thing is that in that almost this October or something, it is just cooling down, is a mineral and rocks and thing like that. Then the plant started. Then in the month of December, early December, then the animals started, then the dinosaurs, and that happened in sometime in the middle of, and this before this 25th of December, that's they disappeared. That then the human created in the almost in the last 2 days of that calendar, the human was created, that caveman and things like that. Whatever known history, you know, you read in the history book, it might, in that calendar, it have happened, might have last few minutes of that calendar, last day of the 31st December. So this is just to understand the, you know, the enormity of the creation. Okay, so, and that creation is everything, even in the minor detail, in the atomic level and this level, it was designed by some intelligent being or some force, some energy. That we call the universal consciousness. It cannot happen by accident. This kind of thing cannot happen. We know very well, if you want to create a simple thing, suppose we wanted to cross the river, you wanted to create a bridge, you know how much you know effort it takes, how much calculation, how much design, how much material resourcing, how much site activity and things like that is needed for that. To there is one, I'm talking some small simple bridge. Okay, think of the whole universe, how much engineering, how much planning, how much resource allocation could have been, you know, involved in doing that. Basically, what I'm saying is, whatever has been created, it is of hugely significance. Why I've given that time scale? Because we look at it a very short part of it, so we miss the bigger picture, and that the short part misled us. That's what that point I'm just coming at. Even our lifetime is so small in that overall scale that even if like we try to understand everything, why this is happening, why that is happening and all these things, we have the several hundreds of lifetimes. And everything has a karmic connection. So basically it is a futile exercise to understand intellectually that we are programmed to. Understand everything, and most of the time we fail, we get frustrated and all this kind of stuff. It comes as a part of it. So what is the key then? Key is, if we realize that everything is happening for a purpose, nothing is by accident. If something is happening in my life, I have my higher version, my soul has planned my life for a purpose again. To have some kind of experience, some kind of growth, some kind of closing previous debt or things like that. And that's what is played out here. So when it is played out here and we keep complaining about things, you know, that is the approach we normally take. So if what happens is, if we keep, you know, pushing that away, the plan will play out. If we don't make it happen, it will just shift to the next life, because that need to be settled. It is all about the energy balance. In the bigger picture, somewhere some wave has gone up, it has to come down. A new wave will come. It will not stand still and there, because this is a nature, this is a dynamic. It is a dynamic situation. We are in a small part of it. Suppose we are just like a small paper boat in a big wave. So initially we are thinking, well, we are climbing up because wave is going up. Then at a at a certain point, then it started going down. We were scared. Why you are going down? We are supposed to go up. We are not supposed to go up. Up and down is a part of that rhythm. If we breathe in, it will breathe out as well. Okay. So this, we don't understand the picture and we keep crying and thing like that. And that's why we take whatever is happening in our life in a so-called negative way. Or so whatever we are wishing for, it is not happening. What is the other type, other side of it? If we just stop that mind business, no? The why it is going up, why it is going down, and all the intellectually analyzing things, we can simply enjoy the ride. When the boat going up with the, you know, wave, we will go up and go down, we'll also enjoy. But to do that, we have to have that trust to that higher self, that I'm in this boat for a reason. I am in this ocean. A ocean is going up and down. That is also for a reason. Okay. Why unnecessarily fight ourselves? We have no, as I given the example, we have absolutely no power to do change anything. So that part, it is always better to go with the flow and accept the things what is already manifested, and it is, there is an already divine plan, our soul's plan, a lot of things are involved into that. The truth is, we, in our soul level, we planned this journey, as I just explained a little earlier. That is our plan. We are the so-called co-director of our script. Of course, we now, when it is incarnated body, they forget that, because that is the purpose. Otherwise, experience will not happen. That also I explained earlier at other sessions. So best approach is to accept the thing as it is, means what is manifested. And it is fact that we all wanted to grow, we wanted to learn, we wanted to be better. There is nothing wrong with that. Now, think of, let me take an example of a school. Okay. That we wanted to go into first, get admitted into, KG1, KG2, then class 1, class 2, class 3, and all those kind of things. So it is our desire to be educated and going higher, pass the thing and go higher and higher classes. Suppose I am in class 3, looking at somebody as class 5, as, oh, he is much, higher than me. I wanted to be that. That's nothing wrong in that. Okay. But think of what we are doing with our life. We are criticizing that this, because we want 5. We are criticizing the teacher of class 3. We are, whatever books are class 3 reading, is useless. I want that. And whatever assignment given, we are not willing to do because we think we are capable of better things. So do you think we'll ever pass class 3 by doing this attitude? And exactly equivalent term we are doing with our life. And that is the reason we never pass class 3. That is the topic of today. If you read the description, non-acceptance of what is, I'm at class 3, that is a fact, that is a reality. Unless until I accept that, the possibility of class 5 does not arise. We keep on failing and being at class 3. When we accept, I'm at class 3, I have to pass class 3, then class 4, then I will be at class 5. Simple, this understanding make the things easier. Accept what it is. You are at class 3. Accept that. No matter how you came and somebody gone faster and somebody is higher, lower, too much of homework, doesn't matter. Whatever it is, whatever it takes, finish class 3, then go to the next class. This graduation, this passing of class 3 cannot happen by criticizing and avoiding and not to accepting it. In other words, suppose you have a ladder. To climb the ladder, unless until you accept the ladder, say number 7 step, you cannot go to 8. You have to step there, accept it, stabilize yourself, then go to the next step. You wanted to climb at the top, it's fine, but that does not mean you don't accept the lower steps. Or, to be truth, accept where you are, no matter where you are. It is a journey. Journey means it has to start somewhere and then it will move forward. If you don't accept, suppose you have to have a long journey, but we don't accept the vehicle. Okay. Suppose we self-criticize ourselves. The vehicle means our body is the vehicle for our life's journey. We self-criticize, having self-doubt, we create more confusion, we have got more kind of, you know, so-called desires, many things. And in fact, the root of all these things is a lack of self-acceptance. We don't accept the vehicle we have been given. Either we don't like the look or the intelligence or the it is capacity to earn or whatever it is. Parameters are many, but we so much subconsciously, we non-acceptance of self is a root cause of our own life's journey and further development. So I hope by quite a few examples I made it clear where the root cause is. Root cause is non-acceptance. Non-acceptance doesn't mean that we should stop the urge to grow. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that is a foundation stone of acceptance. If you don't accept the lower step, how can you go the higher steps? It's not possible. That's why the class school example I have given. You accept that you are in class 3. Nothing wrong with that. Accept that in class 3 I will do my best. Okay. Whatever, you know, as per the design soul's plan, whatever capacity, whatever earning level, whatever intellectual level, whatever education level, whatever the place, whatever family I have given, whatever society I have given, whatever the country I born in, doesn't matter. I accept. Because at soul level I have chosen. When I explained about the, you know, the soul's journey, I explained we choose. We choose parents. We choose what are the type of intelligence we'll have in this life, what is the level of earning capacity we'll have in this life, what will be the relationships we'll have in this life, which country we'll take, but we all decide our soul level. We all decided by ourselves. And when we incarnated, if we don't accept that, our soul's plan gets broken. We don't grow. We come again to learn that same lesson. So everywhere the acceptance is the key. Acceptance does not mean that you have to agree with everything. Okay. If somebody is misbehaving with me. So should I agree that he will continue? I'm not saying that. I'm saying if you accept that this situation I am in and this, then improvement can start working from there. It cannot come from fighting. Fighting will continue. Yes, Pinky?
Yeah, I have a question regarding this. Acceptance, yeah, that is okay. And I can understand acceptance is the key thing. But shouldn't we have aim in life or go for something? Like if it doesn't happen also, if we don't try for it.
Yes, of course we have that. That is what I was just explaining the school example. I wanted to go to class 5. I cannot go there by criticizing and rejecting class 3 material. If we like to achieve the goal, nothing wrong with the goal. But I am talking about, just let us analyze what method we are following to go there. We cannot grow simply by not liking something what we already have. Rather, use it as a foundation stone to grow.
Okay.
Okay, so the approach to be changed, because currently what is means whatever life, whatever stage, whatever situation we are in, it is created by us. We cannot now deny that and assume that further growth will automatically come. It will not happen. The situation we have been created, that is for a purpose. Okay, but as we are not accepting it, it is keep coming back on us. The moment we accept it and learn the lesson, then we grow. That step is no longer required. That situation will automatically fade out. Because we have learned the lesson, that chapter is closed from the soul's plan point of view. Then we can move on. But we are stuck because we are not accepting. We are rather fighting. And that day, I think I was explaining some question and answer. So Shweta has asked some question. Then I've given example of the friends, no, visiting Singapore and visiting London, and the five different friends, they have differently, they have
yes,
behaved.
Sir. Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Okay, so we that more gift will come who are appreciating what they have, what they already got. That is a natural law. That's what I explained that time. We cannot get more, or we cannot achieve our target by criticizing what we have. So that's why the first set, the friends who are criticizing, they didn't get, we don't consider them, they are worth giving any further gift because they're criticizing what they have. Means not accepting what gift they have given. So every moment is a present by the divine. That's why the moment is called, now moment is called present moment. It's a gift. If you don't accept what is in this present moment, we cannot get further. The flow will stop.
I have a question, Rishi.
Yes, Narendraji.
Rishi, that means we have to be appreciating what we have got.
Yes.
And because we got it because of our soul's plan, and obviously that relates to our past karma. Mm. If we have hurt somebody in the past in a particular way, we would face it ourselves to learn a lesson.
Mm.
So we should thank the creator or the divine power for everything, including our hardships.
Yeah.
Even if we are getting a problem now, we should thank him for giving us a problem.
Mm-hmm.
To learn. So we should be all the time thankful and appreciating of what we have, and that is the best way to go forward to the next class. Is that right?
It is right, but you see, just I'm leveling part, I'm just commenting on the leveling part. The good bad thing, no? In the soul level, there is no good bad thing. All are experiences.
Yeah.
So we have to accept the experiences even if you don't like it. Like when some doctor operates our body, suppose removing some kidney stone, it will be painful.
Right.
We have to be, you know, anesthetized, and you have to take rest. We cannot go out for some time. There is a, this process has some kind of element involved, which you don't like.
Yeah.
But it is for our ultimate good.
Right.
So, okay.
So accept,
we have to get from that.
So accept what is coming because it was pre-planned.
Yeah.
Because of circumstances, our past karma, our soul, whatever we may call it.
Yeah.
So it had to happen. So we have to reconcile with the fact that it was supposed to be.
Yeah.
And just be in the present and how it is happening.
Yeah.
And deal with it the best way you can.
Correct. Because that way you can overcome that. Otherwise, you'll keep on coming because you have not learned the lesson.
Mm-hmm.
We are resisting, we are rejecting, we are fighting, we are complaining, but that will not go. Because as per soul's plan, we have to cross karna padega. Okay. So it will keep, same question will keep on coming. If we keep
fighting, we'll get over it finally.
Yeah. So what best approach is, go in the flow, give your best. Okay. Don't criticize, don't, you know, accept.
Okay.
accept this is the reality. I have to accept, I have to give my best. If that approach will take us further.
Don't break.
Because it will be unnecessarily, we call it detour in the soul plan wise. If you do something and start, you know, put our, you know, liking, disliking into our path, then we'll not get the experience. Unnecessarily, we'll create so many ripples and so many detours. Our original plan will take longer than usual. And at the soul level, there is no time. It will wait for millennia. We'll take 50 more births. How does it matter? You know, as I said, it doesn't matter. It's okay. So you take more births, come back again and again. And that's what exactly happening.
Yesterday I was reading a quote from by Yukteswar Giriji, and he said that if you look into the eyes of the fear, the fear will go away.
Correct. In fact, spiritual understanding is anything you pay attention to, it will dissolve.
Right.
Okay, if you wanted to certain bad habit you wanted to get rid of, just pay attention to, don't fight. Okay, we do in our meditation that third step, so watch the thought with aloof attention, no interference.
Right.
The moment you start fighting with that thought, no, it should not come, why it is coming, I'm sitting in a meditation, it is coming and disturbing, it will keep on coming.
Right.
Just simply aloof, get detached. Accept it is my mind passing through. We accept the fact, the reality, it is coming.
Right.
Simply you watch. That is called witness consciousness. Witness consciousness has a power to dissolve the thought. And that's how we go to the next step.
Yes.
Not by fighting.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. God bless you. Any other question? Anybody has any other?
Sir, I would like to.
Yes, Shweta.
Sir, suppose I'm taking an extreme example. Suppose someone is born in, I don't exactly know what is the situation of Afghanistan right now, but Afghanistan faces a lot of bombarding and everything. So suppose someone is a citizen of there and he have some family and somehow he have realized that this is not the life he deserves, and he that person is now, he don't have any contact to go out of that country. So suppose he now accepts that maybe it is my karma or whatever the past experience, whatever the past thing, it is coming into my experience. And he starts praying and doing his spiritual core. And sending gratitude into the world like that, because he cannot, and doing his best. For example, he is asking, using social media or whatever he can. So this procedure will be fine for that person, according to this situation like that.
Oh, of course, any situation. Okay. Means you have to do whatever best. See, physically, if you see the four principles, what our group we posted earlier discussed, it is also in the Facebook page banner we put it. First is protect physically. You have to protect. Then after that, once that is over, means I'm not saying you stand in the middle of where the bombing is happening and praying. It will not happen. Okay. Means we have also given our own intelligence, own way to act appropriately. Okay. So this, first let me answer your question. Then I will tell you some story. In these things, after protecting yourself, do your best, and that the prayer will change the energy of that, you know, your area. So you can accept the reality that I am middle of it, and no matter what, I will do my best and live it there. And if I die, I'll die. Okay. So if you accept and do that, maybe something will happen. You will find a way out and get it to the safety or something like that. But you cannot do it by conspiring. Okay, now they kill me, let me take the gun and kill. That is the terrorism has developed by that way. No, that will not solve it. Okay, you will bind another karma. You kill somebody and you get that karma and you have to again come back to settle that karma. The way you think is a solution may not be. Accept, no matter how painful it is. Once you go through that experience at the soul level, soul doesn't matter. You know, you die, you come again. It's not a big deal for that. But if you accept that, then your soul course is over. The purpose of your life is served. Okay. Either you get to something for the next higher level or next course or next experience, it will disappear somehow. We cannot tell exactly how, but it will. Okay. Now the story part of it, that we have also given instrument, intelligence and intuitions and things like that to guide us. Our soul is our best guru. Only thing, we don't listen. And then we act something out of something, do some stupid things, and we get punished for that, and then we blame God. Oh God, why you are punishing me? God is not punishing or rewarding you. It is with our vibration we attract things in your life. And we have a free will. Whatever we decide, we get it. Free will, nobody can change that. That is a contract with the divine. Somebody comes and says that, okay, my daughter is getting married and to it so and so boy, can you check that the boy will be good? I said, I cannot tell that. Because how that person will behave, I cannot predict that. You know, because it's coming under free will. What they will say and what they will do, it's not anybody's control. Yeah, we can pray so that energetically healing can happen, and you know, some better way they can lead the light, that can be done energetically. But whether somebody is good or bad, how we can say? Somebody can misbehave something, we cannot tell that. It's coming under free will. Anyway, what I'm saying is that the story was about there was a flood, and there was a villager. And he was living in a small house, one-story building. He was a great disciple of Narayan. Okay. So in that, so when the flood came, people ran away from the village. But he was staying at home again. Narayan will save me. I'm sure many of you already heard the story. I'm just telling it once again. So okay. So then some police, announcement came, microphone, everybody leave the area, flood coming. You know, he said, no. Even the police says that I will stay. Narayan will save me. I'm a great bhakt of Narayan. So then that gone, then flood started coming. So that almost when there is a this much deep water, then one boat came. Yeah, he said, come, the flood, it will, house will be full, this thing. You come, he said, no, I'm disciple of Narayan, he will save me. So the boat went. Then water raised up to high, up to almost ceiling level, then he has no other choice to go to the rooftop. And then one helicopter came. He said, I'm sending a ladder, you come up. You know, we'll take you to the safety. He said, no, my Narayan will save me. You know. The helicopter went back, and finally the flood raised and person died. He went to heaven. Just a story. Yeah? There is no such thing called this kind of heaven, but question answer session and Chitragupta and all this kind of stuff. So that is another story. Just take it as a story, yeah? Just because that a lot of people believe in this. So he went to, after death, he went to Narayan. He said, I am your bhakt. I pray to you daily, and thousand times I take your name, I do your bhajan and all. So why I am not saved from the flood? Why I'm giving example? Because you're talking about some, Afghanistan war, no? So this kind of stupidity also happened. That's what I'm saying. So then I am praying and I am your, you know, I do bhajan, I have nothing else to do, I just praise you and things like that, Narayan, why I die and this thing. So then Narayan told him, who do you think came with the microphone with the police? He was also me. The person who sent the boat also me. Who came the helicopter also me. You didn't take it. That is your free will. You have a choice to make. Don't think some Narayan will appear with this, you know, gada and all this kind of flower and all this kind of stuff and they will bless you and then you'll be saved. No, my representatives will come. You have to recognize, accept the help and get it out. So this is just a matter of our understanding, how our free will works. Maybe we are getting help from different ways. We don't recognize it. Okay, so when I say that, when I'm calm sitting here just talking something, I don't talk from my memory, I just channel it. Only thing I pray, whatever you need to know, whatever the things you are facing, let it come through me today, in this moment, the now.
Thank you, sir.
That's
Thank
it. You. Okay. So that answered your question?
Yes, sir, exactly. Very much. More than what I expected.
Right. So this is the overall understanding of the things. You accept the reality, the flood is coming. Then you get the help. We have to protect physically. Nobody else, that Narayan will appear to save you. Okay. That you have to apply. That you have to take care of yourself. Okay. And that's how you go to the safety. All right. Any other question?
Yes, Guruji, I have a question.
Yes, Manali.
Is it our soul's plan that how much advance will be spiritually in this life, or it is our free will that how much we want to advance spiritually?
Mm-hmm. Now, spirituality part is we have to choose with our free will. It will not impose it. Okay, so that part is not decided by the soul. It has to come because of our own experiences. It will only tell you the time has come. It is, you can opt for that. But you still have a right not to accept. Okay, and how much you will progress, that is all about. Because in soul level, there is nothing called enlightenment. It is not possible to get enlightened at soul level. Soul is self-realization, which is only possible in the human body. Okay, so yesterday somebody, some old lady, about 80 years old, she called me and asking a lot of facing the family things and all this. So she is not regular into this our Kriya meditation, just called and take somebody given my number and called, and she is asking me, my so-and-so relative, my daughter is not doing this, my son is not, whatever, you know. And what should I tell her? I said, you are this thing, you are like a sadhu, like a spiritual person, so can you tell me what is that, how, when they will be corrected, when they will be behaving good with me and things like that, you know. So that many people what should I say? First I told them about, see, they are all walking their own soul's path and their free will, you know. I cannot say when they will change, it's impossible for me. So when they will change, or at all they will change or not. But one thing I can tell you. First thing, whatever they do, what they say, only thing you have to make sure you don't allow them to control you. Don't get upset with them. Okay, they said something and leave it there. Why we need to do that? I said that spirituality, that enlightenment, understanding of enlightenment, is you contacted me because you think that I am enlightened, then I am giving you what is the enlightenment is. enlightenment is accept the things as it is. Yeah. In fact, today's topic came to me from that discussion yesterday. Accept the thing, whatever it is, as it is. We are not here. We don't play God here. We don't want to change anything. We have to accept it. And second part is, whatever you will lose at the time of your death. She's also asking when I shall die. Okay. I said, I cannot predict that either. But one thing I can tell you, whatever you will lose at the time of death, you know, all your money, property, position, all relationships, close, distant, enemy, friend, everything you will lose. You lose your home. And you will lose your, lose your name, lose your designation, lose your qualification or intelligence, everything you lose, and last at the end, you lose your body. In an instant, this, it goes, whatever you will lose, just think about it, whatever you will lose at the time of death, if you consciously detach from it, you surrender all those, find out. Which are the things you will lose at the time of death? If you consciously get detached from it, you get enlightened. Okay, as simple as that. So think in that direction. First, you don't allow somebody else to control your mind. Yeah. So because mind is useless in this respect. You know, they will put more into that, fuel into this fire. First, you, whatever they say, it is their business, you know. Means it is all some saying is there. It says that what others think about you, it is none of your business. And that is correct. Okay, it is their issue. You know, even if you don't do anything for somebody, they can praise you. Even if you have done everything, then they can criticize you. You know, that is the funny part of the life story. But anyway, that's a different issue. So here it is all about that. If you go raise above that, then nothing can touch you. You self-realized, you have power coming from inside, and that's how you lead your life.
But Guruji, okay. In this case, like you said, don't fear to your mind, but in this case, if my mind is telling me
that can you speak little, can you bring microphone little closer? Your voice is breaking. Can you bring microphone little closer?
Like my mind is saying now, okay, my mind is saying that I am not advancing enough spiritually. Then I should listen to my mind now. In this case, it is my mind or ego or my intellect. I don't know. But
okay, so that is what my today's topic is. Accept where you are. Na? You are criticizing class three. I accept. Yes. I am at class 3. I am doing whatever best I can. Then you go to class 4. If you keep criticizing, yes, keep doubting. Yeah, that is the topic today. Exactly what you are saying. That's what this topic today. Don't criticize. I am not good. And see, let me tell you one thing. All of us, we are having unique soul's journey. Yeah? Nobody is higher than us, nobody lower than us, and we are walking our own chosen path. It cannot be progressing enough and I'm not good, I mean others are going faster. Forget about others. They are walking their own path. You are walking your path. Only thing what you can, your effort is, you have some, whatever you were yesterday, you are just better than that. That's what you need to do. And that is also what is possible. Okay. You will never see me giving you, you have to to-do list. Today you meditated for say 45 minutes, tomorrow to 1 hour, then next day you 1 hour, 15 minutes, then 2 hour, 3 hour. No. You do whatever possible for you. Okay. Only thing is you be consistent. Automatically the rest of the things will happen. Okay. Don't criticize yourself. Don't feel that you are not good enough. You are well enough, unless until you could not have got chance to meet with any enlightened person in this lifetime. I'm telling you that. Okay, you already have a lot of credit spiritually. Okay, so trust that the process and move forward. Okay. Don't compare yourself to anyone. Okay. Just say, okay, whatever I'm doing my best, and that's it. Leave it there. Okay. Okay.
Guruji,
Nimo, you have a question? Yeah, hurry on, I'll come back to you. Nimo, you have a question?
I was just wondering that if the law of karma is universal in nature, means it's beyond earth plane, if there are other places the intelligent life belongs, is the same rule applies there, if there is any idea for that?
Okay, let me answer that. Two separate issues. Okay. One is about law of karma on planet Earth. It cannot be settled elsewhere, even in the soul level. We have to come back to the same place. Like you are taking a loan from, say, Citibank. You cannot repay to HSBC. Even if you have taken, you have got a lot of money in HSBC bank, but you will still pay to Citibank. You have to settle this account. So whatever you created in Earth, it has to be settled on Earth. You have to come back here to settle it, no matter where else you have positive credit or whatever. You cannot settle this there. Okay. That's the first part of the question. Second part of it is, yes, we have the different parallel dimensions, and we can have our own experience there itself, but that will follow that rule.
Okay.
Like same me, I can have a journey on road. I can also have a journey by air. Different rule will apply. For journey, I have to hire a car. I have to, rent a car or fill the petrol and things like that and move, take the route map. Or I can buy a ticket, sit down in an aeroplane, checked in, and then take a flight. But these two cannot be combined. If I get a police fine on the, while my road journey, I cannot, I have to pay it and settle it there. Okay, it cannot be applied because I have taken a flight ticket, it will automatically dissolve, it will not happen. Okay. So it is a two different parallel. I have a choice to. Yeah, I have a choice to have the wherever we like to go, our first journey there, second journey there, it doesn't matter. But this journey, whatever is creating, it has to be settled there. And whatever the other part was happening there, you have to address that separately.
Okay.
Okay. But it's the same me. Two experiences are different. Two accounts are different. Okay.
Got it. Okay. Thank you.
All right. Okay. God bless you. Hari Om.
Guruji, suppose I have not done well in class 3.
Mm-hmm.
And accepting what it is, a person may tend to feel that this is my future, this is my luck, and it gets stagnated there.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than trying to improve in the next mm-hmm. class, or he may repeat the third class.
Okay.
What is may not lead to, it may lead to stagnation. This ye to meri kismat mein hi tha, aisa hi hona tha.
Okay. So it means you are accepting the kismat, not the reality. That's what you mean. No? Yeah.
See, we are accepting the reality, but we are saying that this was how it was supposed to be played.
No. Suppose. I understand your question. See, it is all your trick of your mind. Okay. Whether you are not accepting it, and we are saying it is not worth pursuing it, it is not going it, it is all are called mind construct. Okay. If you are in that kind of mind trap, you cannot grow also. You have to have that urge to grow.
Correct.
If you lose the urge, whatever be the reason, useful and all, you will stuck there. As simple as that.
Okay.
Okay. So it is your urge will take you there. Suppose you say, I don't want to do any spiritual practice. Nothing will happen. Everything, world will go on its own and you will be stuck there. Okay, till some other time when you decide to move forward, it will come again there.
Okay.
Okay, so it is your choice, your free will. But if you think that I'm stuck, I cannot do anything better, maybe that will be your reality. You actually will not be able to go further. Okay. Because you believe so.
And secondly, please clarify this, that when you are observing your bad habit, how does it dissolve?
This is a technology. So don't go into the technology. That how come a tree which has no sweetness, how the mango sweetness has come into the mango. Okay.
Handi.
I cannot see any wave coming, but TV, I can see a lot of channels, lot of how the so many channels are coming in my room. I don't see anything coming to that TV. No, that is a technology. Okay.
Okay.
So my advice is don't bust your brain into that. Okay.
Just observe that suppose I have got a bad drinking habit.
That happens. Yeah. That there is a spiritual reason for that.
Uh-huh.
It's not logical. It is energetic.
Okay.
Okay. Because the moment you pay attention, I'm trying to explain a little bit. Otherwise, I have to spend a lot of time here on this. Energetically, what is happening that changes? You know, I normally give example of suppose some children, somebody's birthday party, some say 4 or 5 year old children, they're having a birthday party, somebody's house, and in one room, the door is closed and they're throwing pillow at each other, shouting and all jumping on the bed and things like that. Moment one adult enters the room, open the door and enters the room, activity of the children gets reduced, if not stopped. Drastically, they stop shouting and all those kind of things. That automatically happens. Simply beyond because some adult is witnessing.
Correct.
The presence. The adult has not shouted or scolded anyone. This is normally, this thing happens. No, you have experience, correct? This thing
correct.
Happens. Yeah. Same way, whatever your this abnormal behavior or abnormal thoughts, you know, when you bring into the witness, it is similar to that of adult entering into the child who are creating chaos inside the room. Uh-huh. You need not to take any action. Simply watch will reduce activity. It is a natural phenomena. It is an energetic phenomena. Okay. I don't want to go into explaining further, you know, why that happens.
Okay.
Okay. But that happens and that reduces. And it is not logical. I'm again saying.
Okay.
Logically, you cannot conclude why it happens. Yeah. So this, when we use this principle into any of our behavior, that's what the witness consciousness, we are witnessing our own thoughts, our own behavior, whatever all this, you know, erratic behaviors will slowly it will go away.
Okay.
But it all starts with the witnessing.
Just wanted to tell you, Guruji, initially when we started this 1 year ago, this witness consciousness was just not there. But now immediately we come to know and many times we get into that witness mode and we are able to resolve things. Thank you so much.
Good. That's great. Okay. So, all right. So, is there any other question? Yes, Manav.
I just want to know, I have a doubt, I don't know if it is very much relevant to the today's session or not, but I have a doubt, so I want to know as we know that whatever we are doing in the present karma or whatever we did earlier, so we have to come again and again to settle what we have done, right? So I want to know that we are humans, right? But other creatures also exist, like dogs, cats, okay? So I want to know this is also related to the karma which we did earlier, that we are humans and they are other creatures are also there. So I just want to know how much it is related to the karma.
No, it is possible because everything is happening in the art plane. No, it is possible. Okay. But one thing, let me tell you for understanding purposes, only human being has a free will. Okay. Other animals, they don't have a free will. They have a limited will. So they are type of karma and the way it impacts is very, very limited. Okay, because everything is governed by the divine principle and things like that. But a human being has been given authority, like adult children, you know, somebody graduated, now become adult, so they can choose whatever life path they wanted to choose. No? Somebody become a murderer, or somebody become the multimillionaire. It is their you know, path they choose and how they work and things like that. Okay. But a small child who is still under care of the parents, okay, they do sometimes naughty thing. It's okay. But they cannot have that similar type of environment, what the choices, what adults make. So if you, you know, do the animal, because we all face that phase, animal, the plant is still limited. So plant has absolutely cannot have any karma because their movement is also not there. Okay. So slowly, when we go to the human being, they're like an adult child, like an adult person. So they can choose, they have choices, they make much, much independent. And similarly, the repercussions also independent. The protection has gone. In the child, whatever he behave under the guidance of parents, their behavior, what they think, they can just throw pillow at each other and that's it, you know, that kind of thing. But they cannot go and something and murder, plan and murder somebody and go with a car and hit someone. They cannot do, you know, that kind of activity, right? Okay, so the level is different. And because of the free will, they are both ways. It can be very good. It can be also worse. But understanding wise, that is the thing. You know, animals do have, but very limited.
Okay, thank you.
All right.